I think one of the most important things that we should be addressing today is our diet. Because Corona sees no boundaries, no boundaries of age, height, gender, sex. The only thing that stands between us and the virus is our immunity. And the only thing that improves your immunity is how you are going to eat. If you have to eat well-balanced meals which are enriched on all fronts, including proteins, carbs, vitamins, minerals, because vitamins and minerals, although required in small quantities such as magnesium, zinc, are very, very vital to your immunity. Therefore, eating a very well-balanced plate is the only way to be able to beat the virus. I think you may all have heard of the new restaurant that has opened that serves very good, well-balanced meals. Well, it's called The Kitchen. Yes, there is boredom, so we need food that is tasty on our tongue. But tasty food can be made very, very nutritious since we do have time. And we can look up lots of recipes, make it balanced, yummy, delicious, and use the restaurant that works, that is available 24/7, does home delivery, room-to-room delivery, and use the kitchen service and improve your health, because that's the only way to stay strong during COVID times. Well, our forefathers had knowledge that we are today learning. Today, science is proving everything that they have done for centuries and decades. What was done tens of thousands of years ago is today what is coming into highlight, one of the most important ones being turmeric. Now, turmeric has an active ingredient which is called curcumin. Now, curcumin is antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral, antimicrobial, and therefore gives your body this innate boost in terms of its immunity, its fighting capacity, it keeps infection at bay, it improves cell repair, and therefore recovery and phagocytosis. So I think one of the great superfoods that is available to us in our Indian kitchen is turmeric. Of course, everything else that we do in terms of using cinnamon, making kadas, using neem and tulsi and basil as fresh herbs, which are so predominantly used in our cuisine, I think all of them are the little cherry on the cake. Eating a well-balanced Indian thali, but using these herbs as well as spices such as cinnamon and pepper, all of these are adding to your immunity factor. So we must be using everything that we have in terms of good age-old kadas and fresh haldi and fresh haldi lattes, fresh haldi pickles, and use those to enhance your immunity to all the way up. Well, I think one of the most important angles that we need to look at are, let's give you five nutrients which will help you boost up your immunity factor. One of them is protein. Your white blood cells and WBCs and all cells in the body are innately made up of good amount of protein. If the protein intake of your diet is good, automatically your inherent immunity becomes stronger. So please have meals which are very well balanced. All your main meals, such as breakfast, lunch and dinner, should be 1/4 of the plate should be protein. So keep high importance on protein quotient, whether it's lean chicken or fish or egg whites, or if you're vegetarian, dals and pulses and legumes and soya bean, those could be all rich factors that are adding to the protein intake and therefore your immunity. Another front that we should be looking at is vitamin B12, because B12 is extremely important for your immunity, and most vegetarian and vegans are not getting this B12 because B12 is predominantly found in animal food. So I would keep a strong focus on B12. If you are vegetarian, then do take oral supplementation, check with your doctor or your nutritionist, anywhere between 500 to 1500 micrograms on a daily basis for about 1 to 2 months is a good way to step up your immunity. Zinc is another cofactor which is vital for nutrition and immunity. About 20 to 30 milligrams supplementation zinc can be taken in consultation with your doctor. Vitamin C, and vitamin C is very variedly available and freely available to us from the plate and the pill. So use the fresh avla or peru and all the fruits that are available to us in terms of citrus fruits, as well as taking a 1000 milligrams of supplementation with vitamin C, because that is important for collagen production and therefore helps your oral nasal passage be able to trap the virus and kill the virus so before it enters into our lungs and therefore causes trouble to our body. And lastly, I would say hydration is very important to keep your immunity levels up. water is extremely crucial. And if you are not drinking enough water, all your cells are functioning suboptimally. The mitochondria in each cell is not able to do the job of energy renewal, and therefore removing the wastes, clearing out the toxins, repairing the dead cells, excreting those, creating new cells, and all of this requires good hydration levels. So please make sure that water intake is kept to its optimum.